السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ۔ شبہات کا ازالہ پیج کو سبسکرائب کریں اور بیل آئیکن دبائیں سب سے پہلے ویڈیو دیکھنے کے لیے۔
ہیڈ سیکرٹری جنرل آف دا وفاق المدارس اینڈ آف دا اتحاد تنظیمات مدارس پاکستان، پرنسپل آف جامعہ فاروقیہ کراچی، حضرت شیخ الحدیث مولانا سلیم اللہ خان صاحب رحمۃ اللہ علیہ، 21 محرم 1438، 23 اکتوبر 2016۔ بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم۔ ریسپیکٹڈ مولانا سید شاہد سارنگ پوری، مے اللہ پروٹیکٹ ہم، السلام علیکم ورحمۃ اللہ وبرکاتہ۔ دس لولی سول از ایکسٹریملی ریسٹلیس ڈیو ٹو دا ویوز آف انٹرنل ڈفرینسز دیٹ ہیو سرفیسڈ ایٹ دا تبلیغی مرکز بستی حضرت نظام الدین انڈیا۔ Utterly distressed with these happenings, I had written several letters to the zimmedars of Hazrat Nizamuddin, the influential class and the ulama of India, wherein I had urged them for the sake of Allah Ta'ala to rescue this mubarak effort of da'wah and tabligh, understanding it to be their own, knowing that the post system between India and Pakistan is very uncertain. As an extra precautionary measure, this lowly servant had sent all the letters to the son of Maulana Najmul Hasan Thanvi, Mutawalli of Khanqa Imdadiya Thana Bhavan, who is Maulvi Huzaifa Thanvi, via email. After he had promised to have them immediately delivered to their recipient, I expected him to have fulfilled his promise in a responsible manner. However, the negligence he had exhibited in this regard is absolutely sorrowful and regretful from a Sharia and ethical point of view. More specially, after being linked to such a buzurg like Hazrat Hakimul Ummat Thanvi Rahmatullahi Alayh, who was very meticulous in his dealings. Nonetheless, among the letters was a letter that this lowly soul had communally sent to Maulana Sayyid Muhammad Talha Sahab Kandhalvi and yourself. From your reply, it is apparent that you had received this letter from another source many weeks later. Regarding your reply, only added salt to the wound of my restlessness and agony. The actual dispute in Nizamuddin is over Shuraiyat and Imarat. Most of the Tablighi Hazrat of India and Pakistan are in favor of Shuraiyat, whilst Maulana Muhammad Saad Hafizahullah is adamant upon Imarat. This lowly soul had read your letter with much concentration. In it, you were adamant on the viewpoint of Shuraiyat. But the basis of your insistence was nothing but mukashifat and manamat, spiritual visual inspirations and dreams. After reading your letter, this thought began to trouble me that in which direction are those heading who were supposed to be linked to the Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Deoband, and the direct beneficiaries of the very same elders? Our maslak stands out from the others on these very ground. According to us, after the closure of the door of revelation, decisions are to be taken based on the Quran, Sunnah, and Ijtihad. That is truly exerting one's juristic mental faculty in finding a solution to a legal question. As far as mukashafat and dreams are concerned, they may serve as a supportive proof, that is to console one to now go forward and treat the pathway one has opted for based on the study of Quran and Hadith, or as warning for treading a specific pathway. Allah forbide if the administration of this effort of da'wah and tabligh is made to lie on such foundations, then where will this work end up? Then how will the correct methodology of this work be upheld and the mistake be rectified? The moment any mistake is pointed out or any decisions are taken based on proofs, someone will present some mukashafa. A point worthy of note is that after the demise of Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, such differences broke out between the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, which eventually led to internal fighting. There no one had presented his mukashafa, nor was any decision taken on the basis of dream. More so, you are well aware that not long ago, at the Pakistani Tablighi Markaz Raivand, what a dangerous direction the work began to head towards due to these mukashafat. After a brief study of Quran and Sunnah, this lowly soul's inclination is toward Imarat. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had stressed the importance of obeying the Amir in countless ahadith and warned against disobeying the Amir. It is inappropriate for me to reproduce those ahadith before an alim like yourself. No doubt a shura is of utmost importance. However, it will be an advising council for the Amir. According to how upright the pious the shura will be, they will be able to keep the Amir upright. This is what Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu referred to when he uttered these words filled with eloquence in his khutbah of Khilafah. فَإِنْ أَحْسَنْتَ فَأَعِينُنِي وَإِنْ زَاغَتَّ فَقُومُونِي. If I am upright, support me, and if I deviate, then correct me. These statements of Sayyidina Siddiq Akbar radiallahu anhu serve as a meaning of guidance for us today as well. Therefore, the statement uttered by some tablighi friends, Imarat means handing over this universal work of dawah and tabligh to the understanding of one individual is not correct. The shura and the ahlul hal wal aqd are there in place for these very purposes, that is to encourage and support the Amir in his good actions and rectify him when he slips. And Allah forbid, if the matter reaches beyond the scope of rectification, then he should be dismissed from the post of Imarat. Nonetheless, according to this lowly soul, the existence of a shura without an Amir is something futile. This lowly soul had written to yourself and Maulana Talha Kandhalvi Hafizahullah, expecting that you people would practically do everything possible to put an end to this dispute. However, your letter was completely biased, that is only in support of shuraiyat, whilst Maulana Muhammad Talha Sahab's letter, which was floating on the internet and had also reached this lowly soul, is a clearly image of low morale and defeat. This is the time to practically get onto the fields side by side with duas. Otherwise, it is clear that the sole effort of ours that has pulled through more than half century free of dispute will become prey of mayhem and chaos, thereby losing its spirituality, activity and pivotal nature. This will be our greatest failure. This type of thinking is synonymous to destroying this effort of our aslaf, for which we will be regarded as criminal in the court of Allah Ta'ala. This all is beside the disgraceful face that we will have to meet our elders with on the day of Qiyamah. This lowly soul begs Allah Ta'ala to grant us the correct understanding of deen and a passion to protect it and such visualization of akhirat which will save us from the embarrassment of that day. Until we do not rectify this mindset of ours, that is, this is an internal dispute of Tablighi Jamaat, wherein we will not involve ourselves. If we are asked of our opinion, we shall present it and understand this work to be ours. It is impossible for the situation to be rectified. Dawah and Tabligh is our own work. It is the fruits of the effort of our Buzurgs. And Alhamdulillah, its goodness is still ghalib. May Allah Ta'ala protect this work and grant us the tawfiq to recognize its value. Ameen. This lowly soul again begs you to revive your opinion and not to make this mubarak effort of dawah and tabligh subjected to your experience and ideas, but rather utilize your dini and as well as worldly influence, being unbiased, keeping this universal effect, ruhaniyat and pivotal nature of this work in mind. Make all out efforts in rectifying this situation. Wassalam. Salimullah Khan, Khadim Principal of Jamia Farukhia Karachi, the head of the Wifaqul Madaris and of the Ittihad Tanzimat Madaris of Pakistan, 21st Muharram 1438, 23rd October 2016.